of my favorite parts of working with these great, great, great composers is that there's plenty of things that meet the eye and meet the ear, but there are plenty of things that don't meet the eye and only meet the ear if you're actually listening. What's so beautiful about esa-pekka Salonen is he handles music that has the full weight of tragedy and the full achievement of transcendence with personal modesty that allows those life-changing things to occur untainted by human willpower. And of course, what appealed to esa-pekka was this combination of Oedipus Rex, which is a tremendous, powerful orchestral piece with a large male chorus and spectacular soloists, followed by Symphony of Psalms, which is a reduced orchestra without strings and a small chorus. And it's music that ends quietly, modestly, without calling any attention to the maestro. Oedipus Rex by Stravinsky is a piece that we have a long association with. I was told to deal with that piece by a high school teacher when I was 16, who put a recording of that piece into my hands and said, "Peter, you have to deal with this." Meanwhile, esa-pekka made one of the great recordings of it, and with the Patrice Chéreau narrating it and, Swedish forces and, an amazing cast. So it's been a piece that esa-pekka identifies with and has identified with for years and years and years. Of course, the material, Oedipus Rex, is a tragedy of somebody who imagines themselves to be really important. And it's all about the human pride, somebody who prides himself on being the best, the brightest, the most intelligent, the most insightful, the most everything. And it turns out he doesn't know the simplest things about who he really is. And all of his knowledge and celebrity and can-do attitude and influence, and turns out to be worthless. It's a devastating piece. The evening when they put the two pieces next to each other, you get this violence and tragedy of the first piece, and you get the benediction and quiet spiritual glow of the second piece. The words of Symphony of Psalms are, "I come as a stranger, as all my fathers were." And you get this beggar who is a stranger forever, who arrives at the place of his transcendent vanishing from this world and says, "Put into my mouth a new song," which of course is also what Igor Stravinsky, the composer, is praying for. So when he writes prayer to God, "Put into my mouth a new song," it comes from the core of his being.